the selfish person. It's like that one person, which kind of multiplies because it's like everyone in the morning, peak hours, want to get into the underground and like the tube, and they don't want to wait for the other people to come out. Why would I wait? Why would I wait? I'll just walk in. That's the first reaction they have. And it's just so annoying because when I'm the person coming out, it's really annoying. Like, it's actually really annoying because I just want to have to stop.
It's basic etiquette. And then there's always a smelly person in the underground. Like, no offense to people who don't shower in the morning, which is fine if you don't shower in the morning, but this is why the French invented perfumes, guys, for you to wear them when you can't shower. Or deodorant, just make an effort, wear deodorant and brush your teeth. Don't come telling me where stop comes next when your breath smells like. No.
So you stand here, I'll just hold the thing and you smell.
Right? And then like, come on, that's not acceptable.
I have an extra shower today.
Ew. Okay, she doesn't smell.
The no filter. I mean, this person does not filter the language. Like, no, no, why would I do that? Well, I don't care. I'll just say all this kind of beep, 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 beep. Because it's appropriate, right? There's a kid next to me. There's this other person, the older person. No one cares. Like, everyone, it's just fine. It's not.
So the forever lost are those people who are running, you know, they're clearly late for the underground or bus or whatever, and then they get to the, you know, the booth and they can't find their oyster. They're the people who are taking literally everything out of their bags, like whole world that they have stuffed in their bag, and just trying to find their oyster, which is clearly in their pocket the whole time, and they're really everybody late. That's not right.
So there are some type of people that are the ones that are always on happy hours. Like always, 10 a.m., 3 p.m., anything, always on happy hour. They just stink of like alcohol and I can smell them from far. Just have cornflakes in the morning. Why do you want to be in the morning? Or something else.
So the sharers, they're those people that are so loud on the underground. Like, give it a thumbs up to this video if you know what I mean. Obviously, the whole bus is listening to your conversation because you're that ridiculously loud, and your conversation doesn't even make sense. It's just stupidity about high school dramas that nobody cares about.
And then there are the people that are the nosy ones. I mean,
the people that are like texting, and then the other people that are like trying to peep over your shoulder as if they know who you are and they can't understand exactly what you're saying.
You shouldn't say that.
I'm guilty of this. I do it all the time, especially when people are playing Candy Crush and I can see that there's a like a perfect move for them, but then they don't do it. I'm like, no wonder you lost, you idiotic, useless person who can't play Candy Crush. But people who stand on the wrong side of the escalators here in London, so annoying, literally are all the tourists who can't read the signs.
Everyone is standing on one side. On one side. And then there's this one odd person on the other one. Like, why would you do that? Just stay in your lane. Just stay in your lane.
Follow the crowd.
I know. The cousins of the pig. Remember the smiley pigs? These are the cousins of those people. Who just litter everywhere. I mean, put your trash somewhere else. Just take it with you. Why would you put it inside the tube when someone else is going to sit or wants to sit? Because apparently they're not going to sit with that thing there. Why would you do that? Just take it outside. And there's so many bins like around London. Just put it somewhere else.
So these are like the real humans that, you know, we see around every single day. They're just always everywhere in town, and this is
inside the platforms,
inside the metro sometimes as well, and you know exactly what I'm talking about. These are the pigeons, and they're not even scared of the freaking people that are sitting next to them or trying to shoo them away. Like, you try to shoo
them. We are scared of them.
I am terrified of pigeons. If you try to shoo away a pigeon, it will not run. It will just kind of like walk away from you. And it's like, why? You're this small and I'm this big. You should be scared of me. But they're not.
Then we have the overly excited creatures. You know who I'm talking about. The kids. Kids and the not so kids, but not adult kids. That those kind of people who are like loud, annoying, singing things that I don't even understand what they're saying, and like singing anything.
Like school trips that go on.
Ooh.
No, just stay home, go somewhere else, take a bus, private bus just for yourselves, Don't come in the underground when it's full of other people. Everybody finds you annoying. I'm sure it's not just us. So these are the people who find the necessary need from within, from the bottom of their hearts, to groom themselves in public transportation. Doing their makeup, clipping their nails, shaving their legs, dressing themselves, combing their hair, blow drying their hair, whatever they think they find necessary to do in the underground, and they don't think it's appropriate to do it at home. Like, I don't get it. Stop. First of all, your makeup's not even gonna come out nicely because you're in the underground or in the bus and it's like shaky, so you're not even gonna do it properly. Why can't you just wake up 10 minutes earlier and do this in your house? And you will look way better. And nobody will hate on you. Or nobody will take pictures of you and send it on Snapchat.
Like we do. Well, we do Snapchat you.
Oh my god.
The sick person. Then one person, stop doing that. Stop doing that. Then one person will be like sniffing and coughing and you can hear them like miles away and you're like, oh my god, please stay away from me.
These are people who sing. I don't know if some of you guys have experienced this, but people that sing in the underground with their headphones on, it's like, no, who gave you permission to think that you're Beyonce and can you, the fact that you can sing? No. If you're there singing for money, that's different, but if you're there singing because your music's way too loud, clearly.
Oh my god, and when you can hear the music, and it just bugs me. It's like, I want my peace, I want to be here, sit here, and not listen to your music. Last but not least, the PDA. You.
Just get a room.
I mean, I don't have words for this.
Just, everybody's uncomfortable, you're uncomfortable, I'm uncomfortable. Go home. Do us all a favor and go home.